Here I have a camera, and I'd like to make it follow me as I move around the world. Here's how I go about doing so. Well, before I do that, I also have this particle emitter that I want to lock onto the player so that I can fill out the world of particles without actually having to spawn a ton of them. This will be a little simpler, so let's do that one first. Now, this is just a game object with a particle system with these settings applied. So, we just need to write some code to make it follow the local player. With the object selected, I'm going to go create component Udon behavior, and now it's time to create a script to go inside this Udon behavior component. I'm going to come down to my project window and right click create VRChat Udon Udon Graph Program Asset, and I'm going to call it Object Follower Script. And then I'm going to open up the Udon graph. Now that we're in the graph, it's time to write our code. Now, unfortunately, we are unable to attach our object to our player. So, we instead want to update its position to be where the player is, and if we do this often enough, the object will appear to be attached to the player. So, I'm just going to come over to my graph and right click create node, this will cover the spacebar, and go transform set position and rotation. Whenever this node is called, it will set the transform's position and rotation to be the same as the vector-free and quaternion shown here. As for the instance slot, this will default to this game object, so we can leave it blank. So, we should say where we want it to teleport to. As we want it to teleport to the local player, I'm just going to go create node, networking, get local player. I'm then going to put the resulting player API into a player API get position node, and then plug that into the position slot. I'm then also going to plug the player API into a player API get rotation node, and plug that into the rotation slot. So now, whenever this node is called, it'll grab the local player, grab its position and rotation, and set the transform of the object to be the same. Now we're just going to say when we want this node to be called. I'm just going to go create node event update, and plug that into the arrow slot of the set position and rotation node. So now, once every frame, it'll update the position and rotation of the transform to match that of the local player. By the way, if we replace the player API get position node with a player API get tracking data plugged into a player API tracking data get position node, we can then also get the position of the player's headset or either their hands. This node also works for non-humanoid avatars and desktop players. Okay, so coming back to what we had, while this would work, there is an optimization that we should do. When we play this networking get local player node, we essentially go into the network script and asking what the local player is. And we are doing this once every frame. Instead, we should really ask what the local player is when the game starts, and then store that value so we don't have to keep asking who the local player is, as the local player will never change. So, to do that, I'm going to come over to my variables tab, and I'm going to create a player API, and I'm going to call it local player. I'm then going to drag and drop it into the scene while holding control to get a node that will set it. I'm then going to plug our networking get local player node into it. So, we just need to say when we want this node to be called. I'm going to go create node event start, and plug that into the arrow slot. So now, when we load into the world, it will set our variable to be the local player. Now that we have the local player, we can replace our networking get local player node with our new variable. So now if we hit compile and come back into our scene view, we want to select our game object and drag and drop our script into the Udon behavior component slot. And now, if we were to test this, we can see that as the player moves around, so too does the particle emitter. Awesome! Okay, so now this works all well and good for our particle emitter, but if we were to apply the script to our camera, we can see that it gets locked to our feet instead of floating in front of us. This is because the script changes the location of the object to line up the player's origin point, which is positioned at the player's feet. So, we just need a way to create an offset. Now, I debate about showing how to code this with a vector-free and multiplying it by the rotation of a player, but by far the easiest way to do this is to make the camera a child of an empty game object with the script on it. Then, you can just offset the camera and it should keep that offset. So, I'm just going to come into my hierarchy and create an empty game object. I'm going to call it player follower, and I'm going to add our Udon script to it. Then, I just want to drag and drop my camera onto it to make it a child of it. I'm then going to reset its position and rotation, and give it a rough offset. And so now, if I was to playtest this, now that the game is running, we can fine-tune its location to be where we want it to be. Once you're happy with where the object is, you can just hit this drop-down menu and go copy component. Then I'm going to stop playing. And now when we stop playing, we will see the values reset to what they were, but we can now use the drop-down menu and go paste component values to get what we had before. And now when we playtest this again, we should see the camera having the offset that we just made. Awesome! Okay, so we now have our camera offset from the player, but this is all happening locally. What if we wanted this to work globally so that the camera will follow a particular player in the scene? Well, if we were to open up the Udon graph, the way we have set up the script is that the camera will follow whatever player API the variable local player is set to. If we were to change its name to something more appropriate like target player, we can see that we just need to change the target player to change what player's position it is referencing. Now, you could select what player you wanted to follow a number of different ways, but for this tutorial, the simplest method is just to use the owner of this object. So, if I was to place a networking get local player node with a networking get owner node, now the object will follow the owner of the object instead of the local player. However, currently it's only checking what player is the owner when the game starts. If the owner of the object changed, it wouldn't update, and if the owner left, it would crash the script. So, I also want to go create node event on ownership transferred and also plug that into the arrow slot. So now whenever the owner changes, it will update the target player to the new owner. Awesome! Also, as a side note, as we don't currently have any ways for the owner to change, this will just default to the instance owner. Now that we have that set up, it's time to test this. I'm just going to hit compile and build and test with three instances to test out the networking. Now that we're in the world, we can see that the object follows the instance owner for all players. If we were to close the instance with the current owner, we can see that it changes the target player to the new owner of the object. So, hopefully you found this helpful. Feel free to leave a like on the video if you liked it, leave a comment down below if you have any questions, and feel free to check out some of my other tutorials that I have on the channel. But until next time, bye!